Take somebody, I'm talking dark skin with blue eyes, man, beautiful people. And they took them just because they lighter. That was Indian. It's not cool.
Okay, let me finish reading.
But we celebrate Thanksgiving. Fuck out of here.
Right,
I'm talking about, I seen pictures of a dark skin with blue eyes, broken, beautiful, got killed. Yeah. Why? Because of color, because it was dark. But we got lucky because we are Indian and white. We all brothers. So why should we even kill anybody? White people were slaves, we were slaves, we all slaves. Why are we slaves?
My man. I will bear.
Let it out,
no
bro.
Color, we all been slaves.
I will bear.
So there ain't no about no color.
The indignation of the Lord, because I have sinned against him. Until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me. He will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold the righteousness.
You hear that, though? But the Lord gonna execute judgment, though. He's in the spirit, bro.
Listen. Then she that is my enemy shall see it.
You hear that? The enemy. So listen to this, brother.
Then she that is my enemy shall see it. And shame shall cover her, which said unto me, where is the Lord thy power?
That's how these women do you too. Because especially you come out here doing this work like we do it, the woman comes against you, they'll tell you, that's some bullshit y'all talking about. Mm-hmm. And you better get out of my house with that shit.
I'm like, wow.
Yeah, because these scriptures is against their liberty that they have.
Yeah.
You know, totally against their liberty. It's totally against these women's beliefs, period.
Exactly. Right.
You
know, automatic.
Totally against all these women's beliefs, man.
We got more God in them than them. Simple fact, well, they the ones that gave us sin.
Hey, the scripture said that actually the woman is supposed to call the man Lord.
He just said, some good point. He said the woman gave us
sign of weirdness. Yeah. It's wicked. Every girl got some weirdness in them, but at the same time, she done, you better wife her. But at the same time, I got even a chick to stand with her. She's weird. But guess what? I'm daddy. I was living there, and she paid the bills, so I'm getting my bread up. A sign of weirdness is wicked. God tell you to mess with. Do that.
I get that in the Ecclesiastes.
You don't mess with a weird girl.
26. Ecclesiastes.
I didn't see all kind of weird girls. You got to mess with somebody to be your wife. You don't mess with nobody that's weird.
Yeah, it ain't safe no more. It ain't safe no more. Just
God tell you,
find the girl,
right there. Nah.
You literally got to put more thought into that woman that you lay it down with now, don't you?
You can't just be going out just popping random women. Because that's how you're going to catch something.
God telling you who to mess with. Don't mess with no weirdo.
Yeah. And there's some weirdos out here for your ass.
You better watch what you fuck.
It says a sign of weirdness.
It says a weird.
And I remember you seeing that, and I was like, all right.
Hey, you right, though, man.
God challenge God. He going to challenge you.
There's some weird bitches out here.
I be challenging myself. I'm be like, let me weird.
Hey, you got that?
No.
It's in 25, my fault. 25 and towards the end, I think.
That's us.
In that book you have in your hand?
I got it.
Hey, start at 19, though. We'll go all the way down. Hey, bro, we got some scriptures for you. Check these scriptures out.
Just throw it in the trash can. Just throw it in the
way. Man, fuck you.
That's your best move.
Why is that devil?
That book, that devil, right there.
Do it while he's looking.
That's why you all battling with y'all.
This is the only book you need is the Bible. That's all y'all.
So what are you doing?
The only book you need is the Bible.
She did throw it in the trash, though.
That's an Edomite right there.
Yeah.
That's her girl.
America.
That's a lot of Seminoles.
Jews is like, I'm a black Jew.
You see,
I told you, that's an Indian.
Yeah.
You know
that
Indians are native
Israelites
too.
Right. Damn, what you call me? That's your girl. Ooh. She said Yahweh. Hey, just look. There you go. Hey, you know what? There is a.
Hey.
Yeah, she gotta catch him.
Nah, Monday.
It's crazy out here today, man.
I would take her home, but no. We got a truck full of real.
She kind of crazy looking.
Yeah, right.
She probably cool, though.
She'll beat it up, though. That's with no makeup on, too.
My boy in the spirit.
Right. Oh, he's about to have a bad day.
There's your girl right there. Who, let's get that scripture out before more craziness comes.
This is Sirach 25 and shit. You started at 19? All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon her. As it climb up ascending way is to the feet of the aged.
And that's a lot of brothers that fell out of the truth, man. They didn't please the Lord, so the more the Lord gave them up to that bitch, you know what I'm saying?
Hey bro, listen to the script.
Doing the work, stop coming out doing the work. Or what, you know what I mean?
This is what we came from.
That wicked woman is given to a wicked ass man.
He ain't even like wearing no cuss shit. What are you wearing? A light green hoodie.
At home sitting down looking all stupid and shit. Waiting for your next order from that bitch, man. Hoodie. Nigga, get up and go to the store for him and give me a pack of squares.
Looking like a real chick.
Nigga, go to work, nigga. Work some overtime, nigga. You become, niggas become slaves to this woman, man.
Look, watch this.
She gonna tell you to cut your beard, too.
Yeah, cut your beard, yeah.
I don't like that.
Nigga, I remember when your hair was bald. Shave the rest of that shit off, nigga. Yeah, my, you was handsome when you didn't have that beard. Right.
That's how my woman told me she like if you look, she, they want you to look pretty.
Right. Man, that's the manliest shit to have is a fucking beard, man. Yeah.
That's why I'm glad I went bald as hell with a beard.
That's some superhero type shit. When you look, that's on your way to having immortality. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. That's your way of immortality, that beard, boy.
Because a man's supposed to be rough and rugged.
That's what separates the male lion from the female lion.
Yep.
That man.
Right.
That
man.
The man.
That man, yeah. That man.
That man. That man. Women out right now. Exercise their authority over it.
Six.
Yeah. You know, say a lot of weak ass men.
Six. Devil.
You're letting it happen.
Check this out.
There was not no motherfucking white Jesus. It was not the name of Jesus. We use it as an American term. But guess what? His name was not Jesus. The white man already, when he seen this, already was amazed by us and wanted to brainwash us because they were scared of us. But if the white man understanding comes to the team, we always accept it. We never fought if they wouldn't. That's why you was called slave runaway. Who you think helped us out get away? White people. You already know. Who do you think dunked this night? You never judge no color.
Check it out. This
because
is
everybody knows she was wrong.
Zondervan Bible Dictionary brother. Right here. Got to get you one of these. This is the definition of beard. It says, a badge of manly dignity as a sign of mourning. It was the customs to pluck it out or cut it off. The Israelites were forbidden to shave off the corners of their beard, probably because it was regarded as a heathenish shrine. And that's what a lot of the Babylonians were doing. Egyptians too.
The ancient, yeah, the Egyptians, all the pharaohs were depicted like smooth faces. Or they have a little fake beard, a goatee or something. But you, and the Romans, all the Romans, that's why they call barbarian. You know the word barber, that means beard. The barb, that's where you get the word barbarian. It means beard. Because you know, the Romans would call all them other tribes that had beards barbarians. They would look down upon you if you had a beard.
It's your boy.
What's up, homie?
Oh, he's on sister.
He just loves humanity.
He's on sister.
Yeah.
He's gay ass.
Trump is wrong. He should never be fucking for Plaza. For all the murders that we do, why is he judging the whole country?
Hey, that's good though, because the Lord put Trump in there, and Trump's gonna end up doing the work of the Lord. Meaning he's gonna bring that death and destruction. Cause the Lord's bringing death to the earth. And that's why get that scripture that said, was it the heathen is the sword? What is that, how'd that go?
Thinking about that.
No, what I'm saying though, the Lord is gonna use, cause anything that happens on the earth happens cause the Lord made it happen. Right. So the reason Trump is in there is he's going to bring division, he's going to bring death, and he's going to bring destruction.
Listen, bro. Psalm 17 and exactly. 13, it says, arise, O Lord, disappoint him, cast him down, deliver my soul from the wicked, which is thy sword.
Yeah, so the wicked, the Lord uses the wicked, you know, to punish his people.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Because our people are wicked as hell, so the Lord will use the devil to punish us. You know what I'm saying? And why there's a great destruction coming. You got thermonuclear wars coming. And Trump could very well be the man to launch those missiles.
Ooh-wee.
He look like he ain't scared to hit the button. He gonna hit the button.
It's already, look, they already went from this paranoid about
This shit's just all over the place.
Yeah, like, yeah. Boy, I got scripture for you.
Oh, it's kind of funny. He's been reading the news. The last couple of days he's been reading the news. Because they are mentioning how...
his newspaper.
How, yeah, how the laptops. It's going to be snuck into airports as bombs. Yeah. Disguised as bombs and shit. That's why he didn't know what he was saying, though. But he just... he's been reading the news, though. That's proof everybody got the internet.
Trump is dumb.
Cell phones, you know what I'm saying? This is the time of the Great Awakening, man. This is it, man. It's time of the Great Awakening, man.
Yeah, that's why they shut down YouTube.
Daniel 12.
Hey, y'all hear? I heard Google lost $750 million.
Ooh, yeah.
You hear about that?
If I try to build that shit, I swear, cause they gonna kill. I swear they're gonna be a sniper every time. Obama gonna set it.
Oh, so good. Obama don't give a shit about us, man.
Obama still home about us.
Because really, behind the scenes, Obama and Trump, they good friends anyway.
He's raised by the guy. He's about the color.
Here we go. Daniel 12:4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book even to the time of the end. For many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
Yeah, knowledge shall be increased. That's why you got all these computers. You got the internet. You know, they didn't have the internet back in the time of the apostles. They was writing epistles. You know what I'm saying? So now we send out these epistles through the four corners of the earth. You know what I'm saying?
Don't know what it's like to have lights turned off or the electricity turned off. Hell, when electricity in the cities go up, you see the mics, man. They got them massive generators.
Yeah,
man.
Generators.
They kick in, man. They got them massive generators, man. That's part of the fucking house, man.
The backup systems, the auxiliary power.
Yeah.
You know, like, I don't know what
it's like, man. These dogs in captivity. Oh, cannibalism.
The kid with the sword is going to be killed with the sword.
Yes, man, we are the number one cannibal.
Well, the cannibal, this is coming on full scale, man.
You ain't about pain.
This is going to come on full scale, man.
We wanted to be
cannibalism coming in full effect.
We was ready to jump off that shit. There is not no number of how many people was trying to jump off that shit. Nobody wanted to be a slave. Motherfuckers dying in their back.
So we still slaves now.
Right? My name ain't Kenny. Your name ain't Kenny. Your name ain't Kenny.
We all still slaves now. What? You know what an employee is?
Guess what?
It's crazy out here. I can't hear
you. You're going to get the mark of the beast.
Yeah, he'll take the mark.
He's going to get it.
I don't bow down to Baal like you gentlemen did.
The bear. He said, we bow down to Baal.
Yeah, go over and follow that guy.
Yeah, follow him. Please don't come back.
Yeah, he's coming back, bro. He found his new brothers. Maybe he'd be cool when he sobers up.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
He just
understand who Esau is. He's Esau. You got to understand that.
That dude got a weird spirit on him.
He's gonna be destroyed, simple as that.
Mm-hmm. Destiny. He's a schizophrenic Edomite or something. Because something.
Here he comes. It is my
fault.
Got his literature.
He got it.
He wants to be burned because he's scared now. All you gotta do is watch the movie Get Out. That's another song.
I keep saying we gotta
because
go see
guess
movie.
What?
Get Out. The Lord's saying we gotta see it.
White Jew is. The white Jew is the black Jew. Black and white.
So the family in Get Out is
they
Jews.
They want to set us up and kill
they're
us.
Jews. Didn't you mention
that's what they want to do. They don't want us to be together. Yes, that's why there is a hell of a cool story. That's why there is.
Kind of confused what to get into. He's just like,
it says you can't really do much with it.
It's rambling. You know what are you talking about? I got
fight,
two scriptures. I don't know where the hell we're at.
Hey, we about reading some scriptures, brother.
I'm going to go back.
We got to let the word of the Most High come out, bro. Yeah.
This is about that precept about Lord, Esau's that's Lord is wicked and sick. It's Isaiah 10:5. O Assyrian, the rod of mine anger and the staff in their hand is my... Sorry, let me read it again. O Assyrian, the rod of mine anger and the staff in their hand is my indignation. I will send him against an hypocritical nation, and against the people of my wrath will I give him a charge. To take the spoil, to take the prey, and to tread them down like the mire of the streets.
That's Israel, like that hypocritical nation. A hypocrite. We are a bunch of hypocrites, man.
never clown.
Yeah, because that was back in the ancient world. The Lord used the Assyrians to punish Israel.
Stop this. We're going to scare them. They don't know. They know we run this world. We are the kings. And then if we know we are the kings, that's when they want us to really go. They don't understand that. They don't want us to be scared of them.
That's
when
right.
When I go up in the coolest store, when I go somewhere and I be behind a white man,
running the spirit.
I'll be this and that.
Throwing gasoline in their fire.
This and that. He's scared. He do this.
He right there.
All right. I sit back and I get wet and I got my beer. I'm like, yeah. Yes, you bow down.
Hey, that's the spirit. That's why Jake always like his jewelry.
I want to bow down now. Get some practice in.
If you want to brainwash, it's a problem.
Better. It's Tobit or something like that. They know that if we turn away from Most High, then we got them. They got us.
This one is
there's a few of them.
White. Judith. Everything. Hold up. Hold up.
Oh, yeah, there's one in Judith. The good one is in Judith.
I'm with all three of y'all. The seven different colors of the dirt
sword. Because other nations knew that. Yeah. If we turn from our Lord.
Yeah, that is in Judith because the dude. It was one of the generals or something. He said that these people, I'm telling you, he said if their God is with them and you mess with them, they unstoppable. But if they sin, it's in the book of Judas.
His name is not Jesus.
There was another one that like scared of us.
My name is Muhammad, but my name is King. I got my ass back.
Listen.
My ancestors.
This is
Judah. Hey, brother, we about to read some scripture, bro.
This is Judah 6:1. This mentions something.
This is a lot of
and when the tumult of men that were about the council was ceased, Helephrenes, the chief captain of the army of Asher, said unto Acher and all the Moabites before all the company of other nations, and who art thou, Achior, and the hirelings of Ephraim, that thou hast prophesied among us today and hast said that we should not make war with the people of Israel because their power will defend them.
Yeah, because he was telling them, like, you don't want to mess with Israel while, you know, while their Lord is with them, while their God is with them. You know what I'm saying? Because if you do, they're unstoppable.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Because their God will defend them, and who is the power but
Nebuchadnezzar,
who will send his power and will destroy them from the face of the earth, and their power shall not deliver them, but we his servants will destroy them as one man, for they are not able to sustain the power of our horses. For with them we will tread them underfoot, and their mountains shall be drunken with their blood, and their fields shall be filled with their dead bodies, and their footsteps shall not be able to stand before us, for they shall utterly perish, saith the king Nebuchadnezzar.
So he's being proud though, because they don't realize when the Lord is with you, you're unstoppable. That's why David was able to defeat Goliath with a rock, and that really happened. That just ain't no fairy tale. that really happened. You know what I'm saying? The Lord gave David power. That wasn't David to kill the Goliath. That was the Lord to kill Goliath. Hey, get that David Goliath. I come up with these with staves and swords.
He was just the vessel.
Samuel, was that 16 or 18?
He was just that vessel.
First Samuel, I think 16 or 18.
And they knew he was the vessel. They knew it was the Lord's power, man.
God comes.
There wasn't no proud motherfucker walking around. That was, see what I did, nigga?
Yeah.
You see what I did, yo, Israel? Yo, Israel, see what I did?
Because there's accounts, too, in the scriptures. When the Israel went out and the Lord wasn't with them, and they went out to battle and the Lord told them not to, they got destroyed. You know what I mean? The people understand faith.
I done met God and I met the devil. I met God. My first love was just like get out the womb. See, but I found the
you know where it's at? First Samuel, I think it's 18. First Samuel 18.
It wasn't no color. My first love was a white girl. And I always was with her. I loved her. A buckle with her over something that wasn't even motherfucking.
White girl was probably a jerk.
Yeah, you know, she was an Israelite.
Yeah.
Let me see that.
Yes.
Oh, 17. Exactly. I knew it was in there somewhere.
Because ain't no Edomite gonna be dealing with no broke ass niggas.
There's the one when they're talking, you know, shit.
I ain't never been broke. I always been.
Yeah, start at 42.
Huh?
You pay?
I have my pay.
Yeah. You got big back.
You say that when you kind of come with the swords and stage? Yeah. Let's start at 42. That's the point.
We put our resources together and we still a bunch of broke ass motherfuckers. You know, we put our resources together and still be broke as a motherfucker. You know? That's why we out here signing and crying. We ain't out here signing and crying because we rich. Oh, Lord, you gave me too much. That don't even sound right. Lord, you gave me much.
But we got the real riches is knowledge, though. Knowledge is real riches.
That's all it is.
Cause gold, silver, bitches, money, that ain't gonna fulfill your spirit. You know what I'm saying? That's why I see all these. That's why all these rich people, they all unhappy. All right.
They like hearing that, man. They like hearing that.
What'd you say?
Y'all ain't seen it. You ain't seen
it. No, I seen it.
I think kind of that Native American, whatever the fuck that bitch was.
You can have that.
Yeah, yeah. She went a little crazy looking.
she gonna do the ghost dance on your ass or something.
Do the rain dance.
Do the rain dance, yes.
They got a dance of destruction too.
Yeah, that's the ghost dance, ain't it?
Oh, the ghost dance. That's the one that were banned.
That's the one that the white man banned because
he actually made a law.
Yeah. Because they would do the ghost dance for hours on end, for days.
Yep.
They would take shifts and they would continue do the ghost dance for days and days and days.
Can you imagine that?
And they said it put the fear.
Can you imagine that? The sound.
Yeah, because they would horrifying. Scare the settlers off.
Yeah, it was quite horrifying, man. Just like when we circle around the walls of Jericho, man.
Oh yeah.
Can you imagine?
That's pretty much the same principle.
Yep.
It's terrible.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah. You think about it like that. Yeah. That was just.
We deserve so much when Trump coming to do it. He's going to get killed. Because you got to understand.
Hey brother, we about to read the scripture. Check this out.
First Samuel 17:42. It says,
so this is how we deal with our enemies, right? That's what the Lord said. Go ahead.
It says, and when the Philistines looked about,
this is going back to David and Goliath. Go ahead.
And saw David, he disdained him, for he was about a youth and ruddy and a fair countenance. And the Philistine said, Philistine, whatever, said
yeah,
to
Philistine.
David.
Yeah, same thing.
Am I a dog that thou comest to me with staffs? And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. And the Philistine said to David, come to me, and I will give thy flesh unto the fowls of the air and to the beasts of the field. Then said David
to... It's a pregame fight talk, you know, the press conference. You know,
yeah.
Like they do now when they go in front of, they talk to each other.
They talking shit.
They get up in their face like this.
Yeah.
Right. And the camera starts snapping and shit.
Yeah, so
that's what's going on now.
Yeah, so the Philistine, Goliath called David a dog, pretty much called him a bitch. You know what I mean? But David, listen to what David said, though.
Okay. Verse 45. Then said David to the Philistine, thou comest to me with a sword and with a spear and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of Yahweh of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defiled. This day will Yahweh deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee, and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcass of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel.
And all the earth did know.